I see
Now,
that so clearly. Yeah.
yeah, now here's two things that I really, really think will help you. We're recording good. Two things, and I've already hit on them, right? The first one is, can Ursula feel? That's the first one. The second one is, can you feel an Ursula? They're contradictory. Listen, can Ursula feel? Yeah. Next question. Can you feel an Ursula?
Right, it's almost like the second question cancels out the first, because if the second
Yeah.
one's true, then the first one has to be false.
Good.
Right?
There's just two simple questions. There's these two simple questions, yeah, is
Okay.
all I would say you
Okay.
need to ponder deeply
Okay. Okay.
and honestly, you do it from this, from here,
From here.
from where you're alive,
Right.
not from here. You don't need to
Right.
do it, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Can Ursula feel? And the answer is no. Can you feel an Ursula? The answer is also no, unless you're telling me you can feel a thought. Because Ursula is a thought. Holy shit. Now, what that does, it cancels out Ursula. Then what are you left with? Just this. You're calling it feeling. I would call it consciousness, awareness, beingness. When you finally know what you're not, you can only be left with what you are. Now, to know what you are, if you wanted to know what you are, what would you do? If you wanted to know what you are, what would you do? If you want to know what you are, what would you do?
Well, I know the way you've taught it is first you have to see what you're not. And
No,
then,
we're past that. If
oh,
you want to
okay.
know, right, if you want to know what you are, what
Yes.
would you do?
What would I do?
What could you
Well,
possibly do?
I'd have to really examine everything that I think I am. I'd have to really look at that. I'd question everything, like,
Yeah, that's still in the realm of
yeah.
discovering what you're not.
Okay.
So I'm not there. We're past that.
Okay.
We're
Okay.
past that, yeah?
Okay.
If you want to discover what you are, what could you possibly do? What are you left with? What could you do? Remember, we're not talking about discovering what you're not now.
Okay. I guess I would, I don't know, just meditate all day long and see what just comes up, because I know the truth is in silence. So maybe I would just stay open and hope that the answer would come. I don't know. I can't think of anything. What could you do to know who you are? Because where
Yeah.
would you go? Who would you ask? Like, there's what, like, there's
Good, good, good.
nothing.
They're all good what you're saying. That's all good what you're saying.
There's nothing
So
out
now what?
there. So the answer
Good.
has to be in here, not out there.
Good. What's in there?
Just that aliveness, I guess, that spirit, or that whatever is keeping the body. Sorry.
What are you experiencing right now? Because
Right now?
you're objectifying it. You're calling it a
Yeah.
spirit or a this or a
Right.
that, or
Right.
you're putting it out there. You're kind of doing
Right.
this, you're doing
Right.
this, but you're
Yeah.
still doing that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So basically, yeah, there's just like, there's something alive here that's aware
Yeah,
of
but you're
what's
objective. You're good. You're right, but you're objectifying it again. You're right.
Oh, okay. I'm going out. Yeah. Okay. So I have
It's
to stay
okay.
in.
It's okay. See, when I say to you, are you being right now? You would say yes.
Yeah.
Now let's good. Now let's ask this question. Are you objectifying that beingness?
Yes.
Why?
I'm object.
Good catch. But my question would be, why? Why are you objectifying your own beingness? Why would you objectify it?
I guess because I totally don't feel one with it. I feel that.
You can't feel one with it. You are it.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
See, that again is mind trying to objectify or object and trying to grasp it. Doesn't need to be grasped.
Yes, that's exactly it. Yeah. Yes.
You're being
That's
now,
fine.
right?
Yes.
But what the mind, good, but I want you, what I want you to do is catch what that mind there keeps doing.
Yeah.
It keeps objectifying it.
Yes.
Objectifying it. That's insane.
Yeah, you're
Oh,
right.
well, if you're talking about the beingness, or if you're talking about the God or the spirit, or what the you are this. Of course the mind would objectify it because it can't experience this. So it objectifies it and comes up with an idea about it. Of course, spirit. You use the word spirit. What's spirit? Let's see what the mind does with that. What's spirit?
Yeah.
It's going to do something with it.
Yeah.
Watch it. What is it? Watch what the mind is. What's spirit, Ursula?
It's the inner aliveness. That's
there you
living
go.
this
Just,
body, living this body mind.
Yeah. Straight away objectified it. Whereas what it actually is you.
What was that? The what? What did
what
you
it actually is you. You're trusting the objectification.
Yes. Yes.
You're trusting that.
Yes.
Instead of your own direct experience.
Yes.
See what it's doing? I'm just trying to get you to see what it does.
Yes, no, this is amazing. What you're I there's a part of me that's like this, and there's another part of me that wants to cry. I don't know why.
Oh, you should let it cry. You should let it come up. Because it's being touched. That's the truth right there, being touched or truly recognized. This that you actually are is being recognized. It's okay. It's okay.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just trying to get you to see, Now let's go back to those two questions just for a sec. Can Ursula feel?
Not if I see Ursula as just an empty shell of thoughts, then she can't feel. No.
Good, good. So then my next question is, who or what's this that's having this feeling? Who or what's this that's where there's tears coming down over the cheeks? Who or what is this that is able to experience just this? It must be you. Don't be shy about claiming you. You're alive. You're conscious. You're aware. The only problem you've ever had is this saying something else. That's all. That's all. And then this gets believed. You can't feel an Ursula. And Ursula can't feel. It's not possible. Yet there's this that's happening. How do we explain that?
Yeah.
How do we explain this? This feeling that you're having right now. How do we explain that? It just is. Is this being directly experienced? Yes.
Yeah.
It's happening. It's happening. Just this, if I can put it in these words, this that's having this experience right now has been, it's constantly being kept calling Ursula. It's not Ursula, it's you. You're...
I mean, it makes such sense. It really does.
Yeah.
The problem is, I expect to feel different. You know, that's the problem. It just feels too ordinary.
I know. But see, look. If I could put it this way, all right? And I don't mean to sound too kind of pink cloudish, right? But
yeah.
If you can arrive home, by the way, you've never left home, but let's, for argument's sake, put it this way, right? If you can arrive home, yeah?
Yeah.
Imagine you've been lost all your life trying to find home. And then one day you find home, yeah? Mm-hmm. What would you want to do? You'd want to just sit at home, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I'd want to stay there. I'd want to stay there. I wouldn't want to go anywhere else. Yeah.
Did you hear what you just said?
I did.
Yeah, good. Yeah. And being at home, now no longer lost. The longer you are at home, yeah, the more home you would feel.
Right.
Of course. And the less this idea of being, the idea of being lost, yeah, would fade. It would get replaced with, oh no, oh, oh,
right.
Oh.
Right.
So you touch on being home and then you go and get lost again.
Yes.
And what exactly I'm saying is, yeah. So, and all that is just getting caught up in there again by being lost again. Right? So, all I'm saying is, yeah, when you touched it, like you touched it a moment ago, when there was tears, you touched it. Stay home. The mind will go, oh, it's a bit ordinary. Don't. When are you going to stop believing that?
Yeah.
Mind is lost. And the mind can never, ever experience being home. Good, there you go. There you are, right there. There you are. There you are. And all I'm encouraging you to do, yeah, stay home. No matter what this says, no matter what it says, because you're here. Beautiful. It's the best session you and I have ever had. The best we've ever had. The best.
Oh, you definitely brought me. I mean, yeah, there's definitely. I don't even feel like talking now.
Yeah. Don't. Trust that.
Okay.
When you said we trust that now. Because you're right. Once you're here, there's nothing to talk about. It's just rejoicing in here-ness. And you just stay there. And you stay there. This might step in. It might step in and go, oh, this is not what I expected it to be. I thought it was going to be more than that. It'll crap on.
Yeah.
And all I'm saying to you is ignore that. Stay home and see what happens.
Okay.
Don't believe this is saying, oh, it's ordinary, or you just stay home. That's it.
Okay. Yeah. And I have to go to an appointment. I have to leave for an appointment about 10 minutes. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to sit quietly, Terrence. Just stay in that. Okay. Beautiful.